Hey guys, welcome to my channel Electronicspedia. Today in this video, I'm going to discuss about how to design synchronous FIFO. In my last video, I have explained about the basics of the FIFO. That is, how do we calculate the read pointer, write pointer, full condition, empty condition, and all of the other basics. So if you haven't watched that video, please go and watch that video. I have given the link in the description box. And also, please subscribe to my channel and watch the video till the end so that you get the clear update. So let's get started. So this is a synchronous FIFO. So the synchronous FIFO is basically the both the read clock as well as the write clock, they work on the same domain. So now this is my FIFO, assume. Okay, what do I have? So I have, this is my FIFO, which is consider, which is a depth of 8, depth equals to 8. Okay, so now that means it has 8 locations. Okay, so now what we have, so the clock that comes in, okay, this is my clock and this is my I'll just mention it as reset. Okay, this is my RST reset. These are my clocks and reset. So the, since the write clock and the read clock are same, okay, out of the same frequency and the same domain, so what we, there is, there will be only one clock we can feed it to the FIFO. Okay, so this is how the synchronous FIFO works. Okay, so this is my synchronous FIFO. Okay, so now what we have, this is a WEN, that means write enable. Now this is my write data. What is the data that you are going to write into the FIFO? Now, usually the FIFOs will be, what we will have, it will just have the clock, enable and the data. So it would be, depends on this, you know, size of the, or the depth of the FIFO. It keeps on first, it immediately after the reset, the write pointer, okay, the address pointer where it has to write it, so that will be set to 0. Similarly, for the read, right, so we will have a read enable and then the read data which goes out, our data, right, this is the data which goes out of the this FIFO memory. So now what we have, one condition is here, so in some cases, okay, so you have to provide it, depends on the how the FIFO has been designed. So assume I am going to mention it as a write address or a write pointer. Okay, address or the pointer are nothing, are the same. Okay, so I'm just mentioning it as a write pointer. So now for the FIFO design, or right, like, you know, we need to have some logic over here that sits like this. This is basically write pointer and full condition generation block logic. Okay, so this generates a write pointer as well as this one. So now similarly at the read pointer also, read side also, we will have a read pointer, RDPTR or RPTR, whatever you can mention. So this is my read pointer, and then we will have empty condition generation logic. Empty condition generation logic. Okay, so now my RPTR. Okay, so now what happens when this is my, assume this is my source. Okay, this is my source. So now I am being the source. What I should do is, if the FIFO is able to accept the new data, okay, then only I should be generating the write enable. Okay, this I should be able to generate the write enable. If the FIFO is already full, okay, that means I cannot write any more data. Okay, so in that case, I should not be generating the write enable and as well as the write data. Okay, I should not be generating. So what I will get from this FIFO pointer logic, I will get the indication back to the source that it's a full. This is my full. So if I see this full condition, right, so I should not be generating the write enable, that means a write data to the FIFO. That's on the full source side, okay, of this one. So now the destination side, okay, the other side, So what happens here? If I'm seeing the empty condition, okay, this is my empty. So what I if I'm seeing the empty condition, this is my destination. I'll just mention destination or some other module, okay, or module or some other module, okay, I don't know. So this is some other module. So that module shouldn't generate the read enable. That means there is no data present in the FIFO, so it shouldn't generate the read enable. So that otherwise this will result in a there is no data and it will result in error conditions. So that what we should do with this the destination block shouldn't generate the read enable. So that's why it has to read look for this empty signal. Okay, now so this is a synchronous FIFO. So now in the last video I have explained about the write pointer, read pointer, how do we take care, I mean for the rollover condition, full length condition and empty condition. Okay, now I'm just going to write the full condition for here. Okay, this is my full condition, taking the example of the say a depth as 8. Okay, so now so for the 8 deep FIFO, so we need a 3 bits to as a write pointer. But what we are going to do, we are going to calculate take a additional extra bit, so for the FIFO full and FIFO empty condition generation. So now that means as per the explanation that I have given yesterday, so the full condition is basically the write pointer of third bit, okay, and write pointer of 2 down to 0 should be exactly equals to the read pointer of 3 down to 0. If this condition happens, this is the full condition. Okay, now the empty condition, what is the empty condition? Empty equals to the write pointer, the both the write pointer, which is a 3 down to 0, should be equals to, okay, this should be equals to the read pointer of 3 down to 0. If this happens, that means this is an empty condition. So that's where we are generating the empty condition. Now what we can do is, now we have this write enable that comes, okay, so here full condition. Okay, so now what we can do is, okay, this full condition I can give it to here. Okay, what I can do is, I'm going to add this. Okay, now only when the FIFO is not full, okay, that time this is my write enable, right, this is a WEN. Okay, this is, I'm going to rename this WREN. okay, so that time I'm going to generate the enable condition for the FIFO. This is just to ensure that there are no spurious writes that are going into the FIFO when the FIFO is full. That's the only additional condition that we are, piece of logic, right? So that is generating. So basically what we'll do, what we are doing is, when the FIFO is full, okay, that time we will block the, okay, so this is the write enables. So that means when this is 1, so that means the output of this will be always a 0. So even though the write enable comes from the source, okay, so then we are not going to write into the FIFO because the FIFO is already full. So we don't want to encounter that, data corruption, of the, because it's going to overwrite the data when it rolls over, the FIFO pointer when it rolls over. So it's going to, cause the data corruption. So that's the reason we are just trying to protect that by adding this logic. This is on the right side, okay. So similarly you can do it on the read, but there is no use because if there is no data, there is no meaning of reading the data. Okay, so this is about the logic that I'm this is going to prevent the spurious writes into the FIFO. So now how does my write pointer increments? So every time it's the source generates the write enable, right? So that means whenever that you know, right enable comes into the, okay, so that means I should be giving this also here also, okay, this right enable. Whenever there is a right enable that comes from the source side, my right pointer is going to increment. So of course this will check for the full condition, okay, so it will check whether the full condition is satisfied or not, and then it is going to generate the right pointer. So right pointer increments every time the right enable comes in, and similarly the read pointer. So read pointer also increments every time the read enable comes, and then also it checks for this empty logic. So this is about the synchronous FIFO. So the only difference that comes to the asynchronous FIFO is, instead of this, that there will be two different clocks, okay, and then there will be two different resets, and then there is some kind of a handshake mechanism that will be present. So that's the reason you need a binary to grid code and grid code to binary conversion, and also some kind of synchronizers that you need. So the only thing that is required for this is, like, when the clock and there will be single clock, and when there is a reset happens, both of my right pointer, okay, this and the read pointer, they will be pointing to the location zero always, okay. So they have to start from the one location, that's a zero location. So this is by default that happens when the reset is asserted. So this is about the synchronous FIFO. I hope the information is clear to you guys, and if there is any query about this, you know, synchronous FIFO, please do let me know in the comment section. I'll be happy to help. Thank you.